वेलकम टू माय केमिस्ट्री चैनल बीएल दास शॉर्ट एंड स्वीट इन केमिस्ट्री। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन ऑफ क्लास 11। नाउ इट इज पार्ट 5। इन पार्ट 5 आई विल एक्सप्लेन हियर द टाइप्स ऑफ रिडॉक्स रिएक्शन। पार्ट 1, पार्ट 2, पार्ट 3, पार्ट 4 I have completed the redox reaction that is oxidation and reduction and types of oxidation and reduction. And also I have explained the electronic concept of redox reaction and also oxidation number, how to calculate oxidation number of an atom in a compound and what is Stark notation. Now here I am going to explain types of redox reaction number 1, that is combination reaction. Now question is, what is combination? Combination means combine. That means you will combine some substance, either element or compound. But what is that actually here in chemical reaction happen? Now see, combination reaction means here either two elements will combine, or maybe one element, or there may be any compound, any substance, maybe one element or maybe both elements, when they combine by any process, they combine, that is called combination. That is very, very important. Either two elements combine or out of two elements, one must be one element. Now see here, the substance, a single substance will form, remember, and combination reaction, two or more elements when combined, they form a single substance AB when combined give C. Now C is a single substance, see here, C is a single substance and AB both are elements here. In some case you can take one element and other one may be any compound. Now, then what are the conditions for a combination reaction? Combination reaction is to be a redox reaction. How can you know? Yes, it is a redox reaction. That is a combination reaction, is a redox reaction. How can we know? That means you will see there are some conditions, then only the combination reaction can say it is one type of redox reaction. Now, first is either A and B, or both and B are elements. I told before, either A and B are elements or A and B, out of A and B, one should be element. Combustion reaction. You know combustion reaction means burning with oxygen. And you know oxygen is an element. Combustion reaction means burning of something, that is called combustion reaction, that is by the help of oxygen something will burn, some compound, some element, any substance will burn, then only it is called combustion reaction. But how can I say this combustion reaction is one type of redox reaction? See here, combustion reaction, combination reaction, where oxygen is used, surely it is one type of redox reaction. So what are the two conditions? Combination is a redox reaction. How can I say A and B both are elements, or either A or B is an element? Second point, that is here, combustion reaction are also called combination reaction, where oxygen is used, and that is one type of redox reaction. Now example here, combination reaction. Now what are the example? Three types of example here I have shown here. Now magnesium, you know magnesium in the form of ribbon available and so solid. Nitrogen is a gas, diatomic molecule, all the gases, elementary gases, diatomic molecule, and so here N2O, the oxidation number, magnesium oxidation number 0, and it is gas form, it is solid form. When both bond, what happened? Here magnesium nitride form. Then what is the formula of magnesium nitride? Mg3N2. Now see, Mg3N2, here nitrogen is minus 3. See, minus 3 into 2, minus 6. And here magnesium, here 3. 3 and magnesium, what is the value, what is the valency? Plus 2 and 3, that is here oxidation number is, what is oxidation number here, that is plus 2, and here multiply by 3 plus 6, Now plus 6 and minus 6, that is sum of the oxidation number in a compound is 0, already you know before previous video. And so this is one important example. Here you can say both are elements and product is also one single one. Now carbon bond with oxygen, carbon bond with both are elements, and also you can say it is a combustion reaction where oxygen is used. So in both sides it is satisfied. So carbon solid, oxygen gas, that is a diatomic molecule, and it gives carbon dioxide. You can see here carbon oxidation number 4 and minus 2 into 2 plus 4, sum of the oxidation number is 0. Last one, methane. Methane is a gas, and here oxygen when bonds. Now see, methane is an compound. In before example, carbon is an element and oxygen is an element. I can say it is a combustion reaction, that is why it is a better combination and also redox reaction. And here you can see here CH4 is one compound, and O2, that is diatomic molecule, oxygen gas, that is in gas form. It is an element, it is a compound, and it is also one type of combustion reaction, because methane bonds with help of oxygen, it gives carbon dioxide and water. What is carbon dioxide formula? CO2, 2 into minus 2, 4, carbon plus 4. So sum of the oxidation number is 0, and here hydrogen plus 1, plus 1 into 2, that is plus 2, here right, plus 2, and oxygen is minus 2, both cancel, and also already it is balanced, and here now, here also you can make balance here, and here it is already balanced. So this is the type of combination reaction, and here you should know, combination reaction are redox reaction when it satisfies these 2 points, either A and B are elements, or one of the AB should be an element. And combustion reaction are combination reaction where oxygen is used, and that is one type of redox reaction. And next we will see what is mean by decomposition reaction. I have explained the type of reaction number 1, that is combination reaction. In combination reaction, one reactant should be element, or both a reactant should be element, either one reactant element or both reactants elements. Now here the second one, decomposition reaction. What is mean by decomposition reaction? It is just opposite to first one, combination reaction. Decomposition reaction is opposite to that combination reaction. Now here see, decomposition reaction, this is also one type of redox reaction, and here a compound will break into two or more simple substance. A compound will break on heating, it break to give two or more simple substance. The simple substance, what happened here, see, at least one should be element. Suppose two substance or more than two produce, okay, but here one should be an element, that is the condition. See here, at least one must be element, and this is opposite to combination reaction. This is very important. One should be the product side, one should be an element. Now then only it will be called redox reaction. Combination reaction is also redox reaction, decomposition reaction is also redox reaction. In decomposition reaction, a compound will break into two or more simple substance, and here one must be an element. Now example, I have taken one example, KClO3, potassium chlorate. Potassium chlorate, what is the formula? KClO3, then see the oxidation number. 3, oxygen 3, chlorine 1, potassium 1. Now minus 2 into 3 minus 6, this is plus 5, this is plus 1. Now see, the sum of the oxidation number is equal to 0, and here K plus Cl minus, here 1 and O2, that is the elementary stage, so it is the oxidation number is 0. Now you can find in the product side, 1 is element, that is oxygen. Now one important point, an example you can say, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate is one solid, and calcium carbonate, that solid, and on heating it gives calcium oxide, carbon dioxide. It is not following the rule that one product side, one is should be an element. It is not following the rule. And see here, calcium carbonate, this is actually it is a decomposition reaction, but it is not redox reaction. You can check by the oxidation number method also. Calcium plus 2 and oxygen 3 into minus 2, that is minus 6. And here, that is why carbon is plus 4, because sum of the oxidation number in a compound of each element, that should be 0. And here calcium oxide is a compound, carbon dioxide is a compound, there is no element. And now carbon, here carbon is plus 4, oxygen, that is here minus 2 into 2 minus 4, and here calcium plus 2, oxygen minus 2, that one solid, whereas carbon dioxide is a gas, but it is not an element, it is a compound. That is why this decomposition reaction is not a redox reaction. That is very important. Redox reaction is not that, because it is not following the rule, one must be an element. And now see, you can check here, this is the opposite of the combination reaction. Then come to displacement reaction. This is very important, and this is one type of redox reaction. And see here, an ion and atom in a compound consists of atoms or ions. Now in this compound, ion or atom can be replaced by an ion or atom of another element. Both elements are not same. In a compound, if an ion or atom is replaced by the other atom ion of another element, then it is called redox reaction. So here, let YZ is a compound where two atoms are there, two elements are there. Now X is another element where here it is replaced. That means here you can say Y is replaced by X. Then X has a power to replace Y from the own place of that compound. That means X is more reactive than Y. That is why it can replace this Y, and it is adjusted there. That means it forms a new compound XZ and a new element, not new element, that is element Y. That means here you can say that X is more powerful than, more reactive than our Y. That is why X replaced that Y in the compound YZ. So now I hope clear. Decomposition reaction, that is opposite to the combination reaction, and compound will break into two or more substance. One must be element. And this is just the opposite to the combination reaction. Example, potassium chlorate, KCl, and it gives 3O2. But decomposition of calcium carbonate is not a redox reaction, because there is no element produced in the product side. And displacement reaction, that is also one type of redox reaction, where an ion or atom of the compound is replaced by an ion or atom of other element. That means, here example, X plus YZ, and Y is replaced by the X. Thus here X is more reactive than Y in the compound YZ. That is why here it can be, Y can be replaced by the X. So next we will see what are the types of displacement reaction. One is metal displacement and other one is non-metal displacement. Then we will see first metal displacement. Then types of displacement. In types of displacement, you can see one is metal displacement and other one is non-metal displacement. In metal displacement, it is clear that metal should be displaced. Then how? Metal displacement, that metal in a compound will be displaced by other metal. That means in compound one metal should be present, and in addition one metal is present, and that is in the compound which metal is present, that is replaced by other metal. And it is very useful metallurgical process, that means extraction of metal process is very useful. Now example, see here CuSO4. CuSO4, that is copper sulfate, and aqueous means solution, copper sulfate solution, that color is blue. Here this color is blue, and when the zinc is added, what happens here? Zinc sulfate is produced, that is colorless. That means here zinc sulfate that is colorless, blue color is discharge, and here Zn, that is oxidation number, is 0 and changes to ZnSO4 in aqua, where it acquires Zn+2. Now similarly Cu+2 changes to Cu, that means +2 changes to 0, and now you can see zinc that loses electron, oxidation takes place. And that is a good reducing agent here. That means it reduces copper +2 to copper. And now it indicates zinc is more reactive than copper, because zinc loses electron and reduces Cu+ to Cu, and Zn is a good reducing agent here. So my second example, chromium oxide, chromium trioxide. Here you can see aluminium is added and the reaction carried, and the product is Al2O3 and chromium solid is produced. Now chromium here, that valence is the oxidation number is +3. It changes to Cr0, where the oxidation number is 0. And here aluminium is there, aluminium changes to +3. Aluminium changes to +3. That means aluminium loses electron. Aluminium loses electron and changes to Al+3. And it reduces Cr+3 to Cr0. It reduces Cr+3 to 0. That means here it is a good reducing agent. Zinc is also a good reducing agent. And aluminium is also good reducing agent, and zinc is better than copper, and aluminium is good reducing agent than chromium. You can say zinc is more reactive than copper, aluminium is more reactive than chromium. Wherever the adding a metal, if we replace the metal present in the compound, then it is called displacement, metal displacement reaction, and the adding metal is a good reducing agent. Now Zn, zinc, aluminium, Al are better reducing agent than copper and chromium. They have greater tendency to lose electrons. I hope it is clear. Now zinc, and in these two example, zinc and aluminium are good reducing agent. They can lose electron easily. That is why indirectly I can say the zinc aluminium are better reducing agent. They have greater tendency to lose electron. What is reducing agent I told before? Reducing agent is one which reduces other and itself oxidize. That means here the zinc and aluminium are good reducing agent. That is why they can replace copper in copper sulfate and chromium in chromium trioxide by the help of zinc and aluminium. That means zinc can displace the copper plus 2 and aluminium can displace Cr plus 3. And now next one is non-metal displacement. In non-metal displacement, there are two types. One is hydrogen displacement, other one is oxygen displacement. I hope it is clear. Type of displacement reaction, two types, metal, non-metal, and metal displacement is that is very useful in metallurgical process. A metal in a compound will be displaced by other metal, and non-metal displacement, there are hydrogen displacement and oxygen displacement. And later we will see what are the examples of non-metal displacement reaction. I told non-metal displacements are two types. One is hydrogen displacement, other one is oxygen displacement. Hydrogen displacement is most important out of two, and here so many examples are there and so many types of hydrogen displacement takes place in non-metal displacement. Now hydrogen displacement, then what is called hydrogen displacement? That means here hydrogen to be displaced, here hydrogen is taken out from the reactant. Now it is one type of non-metal displacement, and also it is one redox reaction. Alkali metals and alkaline earth metal. Alkali metals mean group 1 and alkaline earth metal mean group 2 in the periodic table. Generally alkali metals are very much reactive than alkaline earth metal. That means first group is very reactive than second group. And both are good reducing agent. What is reducing agent? I told, reducing agent is one which reduce other and itself oxidize. Where itself oxidize mean where oxidation takes place. Now they displace hydrogen from cold water. You know water consists of hydrogen and oxygen. They are so reactive that they react with cold water, and hydrogen is displaced from the cold water. Now example, sodium. You know sodium is very reactive. Sodium when react with cold water, immediately sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas evolve. Now see sodium, what is the oxidation number here? It is native state, so oxidation number is 0. And it is in solid state, water, liquid. You take cold water, simple water. And now the product is NaOH, that is in solution stage. So here aqua return, and hydrogen, that is in gas form. And now Na oxidation state is plus 1 and here minus 1. Sodium is plus 1, OH is minus 1. That means here 0 to plus 1. Sodium 0 to sodium plus 1. That means here increase of positive valency. Here oxidation number change. Now here oxidation takes place. Since here 0 to plus 1 or it loses electron, that is why it changes to Na plus. Here it is a good reducing agent. It reduces hydrogen, that here hydrogen plus sign plus oxidation number plus 1, it changes to hydrogen where it is oxidation number 0. So sodium acts as a good reducing agent. Similarly, less reactive metal, generally less reactive metal, they here you can take magnesium special example, and also iron, that is very important, with steam that will react and gives hydrogen gas. Water, from water hydrogen to be displaced, but the condition is not same. Before that it is cold water and here it is steam, that means temperature is high. So let us take example iron. Iron, the oxidation number is 0 because it is native state and it is solid form, and water, that is in steam form. And now what happened? The reaction takes place and ferric oxide is formed. And ferric oxide, see here, the oxidation number is plus 3 and oxygen is minus 2. That means iron oxidation number 0, 2 plus 3. 0, 2 plus 3, that means it is oxidized. Here it is a good reducing agent. Which one? Iron is a good reducing agent. It reduces here hydrogen H plus 2, H2, H plus where oxidation number is plus 1. And here plus 1 changes to 0. And here iron is a good reducing agent. It reduces H plus 2, H, that is hydrogen gas H2, and where their oxidation number is 0. And so iron is a good reducing agent which reduces H plus 2 hydrogen gas and whose oxidation number is 0. Or you can say hydrogen can be displaced from the steam water, vapors of water. Then only reaction takes place and now they are known as less reactive metal. When they react with the steam, they produce hydrogen gas, that means hydrogen to be displaced. And iron is a good reducing agent in this example. Sodium is also a good reducing agent in the first example. Now we will see how the metals react with any acid and how the hydrogen gas is formed, that the hydrogen is to be displaced. We will see in net later. Now next point, so many metals are there, they react with acid and form hydrogen. Evolution of hydrogen takes place. Generally zinc, magnesium when react with dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid. Now see the examples, zinc react with hydrochloric acid dilute, that is aqua, and what is the result? Zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Zinc chloride, ZnCl2, what is the oxidation number of zinc? Plus 2. And chloride, chlorine, that is minus 1. And here hydrochloric acid, hydrogen plus 1. And zinc, that is in native state, that one solid, and it is zero oxidation state. When the reactor zinc react with hydrochloric acid, what is the result? Hydrogen is replaced. And so here zinc is a good reducing agent, and side by side the nature of the zinc is react with hydrochloric acid and gives hydrogen gas, that is hydrogen is replaced from the hydrochloric acid. Next example, magnesium react with dilute HCl and same it gives hydrogen gas whose oxidation number is 0. And zinc, magnesium chloride, magnesium oxidation number is plus 2. And here in native state, Mg0, that means Mg0, the oxidation state 0, it changes to plus 2. That means here oxidation takes place. And here magnesium react to dilute HCl and hydrogen gas is evolved. Similarly, zinc with sulfuric acid also you can observe, and it gives zinc sulfate and hydrogen gas. Zinc sulfate ZnSO4, Zn oxidation number plus 2 and SO4 minus 2 here, and you can see hydrogen, leave that SO4 because you have to find what is the oxidation number of sulfur oxygen like this. Here also I cleared that one, hydrogen plus 1, sulfur plus 6, oxygen minus 2. So here it is satisfied, the oxidation number, sum of the oxidation number in sulfuric acid 0, and here zinc sulfate Zn plus 2, so 0 changes to plus 2 and hydrogen gas evolve. Then after that you will see from these reactions, you can see what is the reactivity metal, how can we know the reactivity of metal. The reactivity of metal depends on that the reaction, how it react with the acid, how it react with the acid and how the hydrogen gas evolve. Evolution of hydrogen gas is very important, how it forms very fast, very slow, that mean moderate. Like this you will find, and we can conclude that reactive metals like this. Now it is an order zinc, so let us three metal, zinc, copper and silver, we can observe zinc is more reactive than copper, than silver, because zinc immediately react to dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid and hydrogen gas is evolved. And similarly, and the reactivity of copper is less than zinc because it is slowly react than compared to zinc. And silver never react with HCl, dilute HCl, and also gold, that is why they are called noble metals. Generally they never react with others, and especially in hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid also they never react. And so here the reactivity like this, zinc is more reactive than copper, than silver. Similarly, sulfur, you can say silver, gold never react with acid. Now it is that reactivity of acid depends on the evolution of hydrogen. Then how can we say evolution of hydrogen takes place? When the metal react with the acid, aqueous acid or dilute acid, you can say hydrogen gas evolve. Similarly, copper also react with concentrated sulfuric acid and hydrogen gas evolve, and so you can say this is the reactivity of metal. After that, reactivity of non-metal. What is, do you mean by reactivity of non-metals? Which are non-metals? Generally, in periodic table, right side, that means 16, 17, these mainly two groups, they are called non-metals generally. And so, what is the reactivity of non-metal? How can we say the reactivity of non-metal? How can you find out? Actually, they are good oxidizing agent. Why they are called good oxidizing agent? Or what is oxidizing agent? Oxidizing agent is one which oxidize other and itself reduce. Reduce mean reduction takes place. Reduction takes place mean gain of electron, accept of electron, gain of electron takes place. So 16 and 17 group elements are non-metals because they are good oxidizing agent. They oxidize other and itself reduce. Example, specially you can say good oxidizing agent or good non-metal, that is 17 groups. What are the elements of 17 groups? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. That means generally fluorine to iodine, it is called generally halogen family. Astatine like little different. And so fluorine to iodine, they are halogen family elements. And so here you can say the decreases from fluorine to iodine, which one? The non-metallic character decreases, and oxidizing character decreases from fluorine to iodine. That means here fluorine is very reactive. According to it, fluorine is good oxidizing agent, that is very reactive. It replaces chlorine, bromine and iodine. It replaces chlorine, bromine and iodine from that chloride, bromide and iodide. But it is not taking place. Then question is why? Because here fluorine has a capacity to react water and replace oxygen. I hope it is clear. Fluorine is very reactive. According to the 17 halogen family, fluorine is more reactive than chlorine, than bromine, than iodine. So, but here fluorine can replace chlorine, bromine, iodine, but it is not taking place because fluorine has a capacity, is capable to react with water and replace oxygen from water. That is why you can't say that fluorine can replace chlorine, bromine, iodine, but chlorine can replace bromine and bromine can replace iodine like this. We will see in, after that we will see how chlorine replaces bromine from the salt, from the bromide salt, and how bromine replaces iodine from the iodide salt. I told fluorine can displace chlorine, bromine, iodine from their respective salt, chloride, bromide and iodide. But it is not possible because fluorine is active very much reactive, but it immediately it attacks water and displaces oxygen from water. That is why it cannot displace potassium bromide solution or maybe potassium iodide solution or potassium chloride solution. But chlorine can displace bromine from potassium bromide solution. Similarly, iodine can be displaced from potassium iodide solution by the help of chlorine. Let us see the reaction. Chlorine oxidation number is 0 and potassium bromide, that is aqueous solution, where potassium shows plus 1 oxidation state and changes to KCl. Now see, here also K plus remain as it is, but chlorine, that is 0 oxidation state, changes to minus 1 oxidation state. I told it is a good oxidizing agent. It oxidizes other and itself reduce. Itself reduce mean itself takes electron, gain electron. That is why chlorine 0 oxidation state changes to Cl minus 1 oxidation state. Similarly, bromide minus 1 and that changes to bromine. That means bromine can be displaced from potassium bromide solution by the help of chlorine. Similarly, chlorine can also displace bromine from potassium bromide solution. Now see here chlorine, and that means here bromine is 0 oxidation state in product side. But important thing is that in potassium chloride it is soluble. In potassium chloride, bromine liquid, bromine is soluble. That is why one layer is formed. Orange layer is formed in the middle of the test tube. That is why it is called layer test. Now it is in the ionic form. Chlorine Br minus, it gives Cl minus and bromine 0 oxidation state. Chlorine is chlorine oxidizes Br minus to bromine and itself reduce. Similarly, second reaction, see here, chlorine oxidation state 0, oxidation number 0, and it react with potassium iodide, where iodide is minus 1, it changes to iodine and chlorine changes to Cl minus. That means chlorine is reduced to chloride ion and oxidized I minus to I2. That means I minus 1 to 0. And here also iodine, that is soluble in water, this is an ionic form equation. And here instead of 2Ki, because K is not required in this reaction, the use of K in this reaction not required. That is why simply we can write I minus, and after balancing that is 2. So chlorine 0, 2I minus, it gives 2Cl minus and I2. And what is the color of I2? That is violet color, and it also soluble in iodine always remain in solid form and potassium carbon tetrachloride is soluble and forms a violet color layer. That is why these two are called layer test, because they form colorful layer according to their soluble in carbon tetrachloride, and bromine respectively orange color form and iodine respectively violet color is formed. That is the ionic form of the equation. Br to 0, 2i minus, and I minus changes to I to 0. That means here 0 to minus 1, it is reduced and it helps to oxidize I minus to 0. So I minus 1 to I to 0. That is why it is a good oxidizing agent. It oxidizes I minus to I2 and itself reduced to Br minus. Then come to what is mean by disproportionation reaction. That means here what happened, suppose when element is there in the reaction and having some oxidation number in the reactant side, in product side we can find the oxidation number also increase and oxidation number also decrease. That mean here in product side it is oxidized and also side by side it is reduced simultaneously. It is called simultaneously. That mean an element in a reaction simultaneously is oxidized and simultaneously it is reduced. That mean oxidation number increases, oxidation number decreases from the which is what is present in the reactant side. Let us see. Here three oxidation states are available, because in reactant side one oxidation state available, in product side two oxidation states more available. That is, one is more than that before in reactant side, one is less than before that present in the reactant side. So element in intermediate oxidation state, the reactant side, suppose it is called intermediate oxidation middle, in between two higher and lower oxidation state. In product side, lower oxidation state and higher oxidation state. In reactant side, that intermediate oxidation state, and product side, one is more oxidation state before that and one is low oxidation state before that. So how many oxidation states are available? Three. One is called reactant side intermediate oxidation state, and right side lower oxidation state and higher oxidation state than that element present in the reactant side. Next we will see more examples about that disproportionation reaction. Now see the example of disproportionation reaction, where you will take here hydrogen peroxide. Two times have hydrogen peroxide in aqueous solution, it gives water and oxygen. Now you can observe what is the oxidation number of oxygen here in hydrogen peroxide. That is minus 1. You can show that 2 into minus 1, that is minus 2. And 2 plus into plus 1, that is plus 2. The sum of the oxidation number is equal to 0. And show here oxidation number of oxygen is minus 1. In product side you can observe that is minus 2. One product is minus 2 and other product, that is oxygen, that is 0. So there are two product, one is water, other one is oxygen. In water the oxidation number of oxygen is minus 2. In oxygen the oxidation number of oxygen is 0. So here in reactant side oxygen is minus 1, product side oxygen minus 1 and 0. That means one is lower oxidation number, other one is higher oxidation number. Minus 1 changes to minus 2, that is lower side, lower oxidation number, and minus 1 to 0, that is higher oxidation number. Now here it is completed different type of that is redox reaction, and now we will see some elements that shows fractional oxidation number. That is also very important, but few cases are there where you can observe what is the fractional oxidation number here. Actually one should know the structure of the particular compound, then only one can calculate the oxidation number in fractional value. C3O2, that is called carbon suboxide. What is C3O2? That is carbon suboxide. You can observe that is here minus 4, 2 into minus 2 minus 4. It should be plus 4, because the sum of the oxidation number equal to 0. Then what is one carbon oxidation number? 4 by 3. But question is, if it is 4 by 3, then how? Two carbons, it is observed, two carbon are plus 2 state and one carbon is 0. But how many carbon? 3 carbon. So plus 2 plus 2, 4 plus 4, and how many carbon? 3. That is why plus 4 by 3, that is the average value of the carbon oxidation number. So we can say oxidation number of carbon in C3O2 is plus 4 by 3. The second one is very important, Br3O8. How many bromine? 3 bromine. And how many oxygen? 8 oxygen. So how can you calculate the oxidation number of bromine here? That is observed, 16 by 3. Oxidation number of bromine is plus 16 by 3. Then how many terminal bromines are there? 2 terminal bromines are there, that is plus 6. 1 middle bromine is there, that is plus 4. And average is plus 16 by 3. Then how it is possible. This is the structure of Br3O8. In middle one bromine, in terminal two bromines are there and three oxygen are there. Here in this side also three oxygen are there, and so bromine shows plus six oxidation state. This bromine shows plus six oxidation state, and this is plus four. That is why total is plus six plus six plus four, and that is equal to 16. And how many bromine? Three bromine. That is why plus 16 by 3. Are you clear? Here two bromines are there. One bromine plus six. One terminal bromine plus six. In middle bromine, that is plus four. So it is plus 16 by 3 average oxidation number. Next, S4O6 tetrathionate. In tetrathionate ion, here also it is observed terminal sulfur. How many terminal sulfur? That is two terminal sulfur. So terminal sulfur two times. So it is two times terminal sulfur, and so that is plus 5, and two middle sulfur also there, and that is why it is 0. So now you can observe how many total sulfur atoms. Four sulfur atoms, two terminal sulfur atom, that is plus 5, and two middle sulfur, that is 0. So you can say how many sulfur? 4. And what is the oxidation number after addition? That is plus 10. So average oxidation number is plus 10 by 4, and that is why the answer is plus 2.5. again, see, S4O6 minus 2, terminal sulfur 2, that is why it is plus 5, and 2 times, so plus 10. Middle sulfur is 0, 2 sulfur, they have value is 0, and average value comes to plus 10 by 4, and that comes to plus 5, 2.5. So the fractional oxidation number of sulfur in tetrathionate ion, and that is comes to plus 2.5. I hope it is clear to you different type of redox reaction. First is combination, then come to decomposition, displacement. Displacements are two types: metal displacement, non-metal displacement. In non-metal displacement, again one is hydrogen displacement, other one is oxygen displacement. Hydrogen displacement, that is very very important, and then come to disproportionation reaction, and after that last, what is fractional oxidation number. In few cases, few compounds are there where you can find, you can observe fractional oxidation number is possible. This is only possible to calculate if you know the structure properly. I hope all the things clear to you, and I hope you will subscribe my channel BL Das Short and Sweet in Chemistry, and also I may hope you will like and share my channel. Thanking you.